guys, today I'm going to solve the box devil. So this is a box from OSCP preparation from TJ Null's guide. So he prepared that guide from during his OSCP preparation. So I am going to solve this box without using of Metasploit, right? So let's try to solve it. So as our IP is 10.10.10.5 for this devil box, let's first of all try to ping that this box 10.10.10.5, right? So it's good to go. So first of all, create a directory, devil, then cd devil, right? Then again make a directory nmap. So guys, basically what I'm doing here, I'm just creating it's my way to taking notes. So I make a directory of each and every machine, right, which I solved during my OSCP exam preparation, and make the folders to optimize all the data. For example, if I want to scan run a nmap, then I create a directory nmap and store all the nmap scans of for that machine in that particular nmap directory, right? So let's run simple and default nmap scan for default ports, that is nmap-vbv for vb for verbose, then sc for default scripts, sv for running service version of running services, right? Then ip address of our machine, right? Then save it as default three formats, one is XML, second one is nmap, and third one is text, right? So named it as save it into nmap directory and save it default nmap, right? So let's run it. During the running of this nmap scan, I'm going to run two more scans of nmap, that will be for nmap dash v for verbose, sc for sv for the running services of version of running service, then dash dash script. It includes all the vuln scripts, right, of NSC scripts, then 10.10.10.5, right, on default ports. Then let's run it. Then also I'm going to run for the UDV ports, right, that will be nmap-vvv-su for UDV ports, then 10.10.10.10.10.5, right? Then let's go to the nmap default scan. It says discovered port 80 and 21. Okay, during the scan, meanwhile let's try to open this IP address 10.10.10.5. okay, so this is a default IIS server, web server, right? Windows web server. So let's copy it and try to run directory buster on this, right? Then go to a nmap scan, what it says. Okay guys, okay, it says 21 is open and FTP anonymous login allowed, good. Then it 80 port option traced get. Okay, so guys, as we can see here, this is there's a FTP server login with anonymous enabled, so we can log into the FTP using anonymous, right, anonymous login. So let's try to log into the FTP, right, using anonymous. Sorry guys, I got a phone call, that's why I paused the video. Okay, so now try to log in to the FTP. So FTP 10.10.10 IP address of our machine, then it says name, then we'll type anonymous, enter, send identity, then password will be also anonymous, right? We are logged in. Then we check dir. So guys, as you can see, we are in the www directory of machine, right? It is a directory where all the web server files are stored, right? Let's try to open this file, HTML file, in browser. IIS. Okay, so yeah, you can see guys, we are able to open this file from browser, right? So here's what I'm thinking. If we able to put some file or reverse shell in this website, this directory, then we can access that reverse shell using browser, right? So let's try to create a file. First of all, go to our OSCP directory, desktop, OSCP, STB, retired, then devel, right? Then here we are going to try to log in the FTP 10.10.10.10.5, right? Anonymous, done. Then open a new tab, then go to our directory, SCP, STB, retired, devel, then we touch, create a file, touch abc.htm, right? Then we again go to our FTP, then put, that was abc.htm. HTML, that is, let's try to open here abc.htm. okay, so we can see we are able to put a file here, right, using FTP. So here what we are going to do, we are just creating a reverse shell using ms7ohm, right? So guys, first of all, let's try to check which type of files we are able to run during using this server, right? Using IIS server. So this is IIS server. So we are able to run here .asp and aspx files, right? So this is IIS. Okay, so copy this and go to Google, then put spotter ASP files. Classic AS installed by default, IIS server, right? So it says we are able to, not able to run .asp files, and update is available, right? So guys, here we can see using the Google and Microsoft IIS server of 7.5, we are able to run the .aspx files, right? Let's dig up a little more. Spotter.asp. Classic not installed. Okay. So guys, as from Google results, we can see we are not able to run the ASP files on IIS 7.5, right? So for that, just we are going to create a .aspx file, right? So for that, just ms7ohm windows shell underscore reverse tcp, right? Lhost equal to, what is my local IP address? That is 10.10.10.14.33. L port will be 1234. Then F for the format, that will be ASPX. Output will be in Kamal projects dot ASPX. Enter. Let it be created. It right. It take 2 or 3 minutes, right? Till then, NC dash L and VP and VP that is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Sorry. Service not available mode, service global. Okay, so we have to again connect with the FTP. First of all, let's see is our payload is created or not. It take 2 or 3 minutes, right? Till then, just go to our FTP result, let it exit. We don't need that. Yes, my UDP ports, which is not any kind of good data which we can use, right? So it's not our, then go to directory plus tree, it's also finding ASP.NET, we don't need that. Okay, so what it says, this was the, it says we don't need that also. It's a little bit time. Let's wait till it's created. Let's I am pausing the video, right? So here we got our payload, right, saved as commonplex.exe successfully. We created a payload, right? So let's see, is we have a payload, right, here commonplex.exe, right? So let's go to try to connect our FTP, right? So FTP for 10.5, right? It says for username that will be anonymous, right, logged in, then put Kamal projects, done. So let's go to, so here you can see we are able open a listener that's for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 port, then go to our browser and try to Kamal projects, right, dot aspx, then try to open, it says there we got an error, right, resource cannot be found. So let me check where we have made a mistake. Dir, we have a file name called projects, right, copy selection, I think I have mistyped something. Then we go to, right, here you can see, guys, we got our shell. Right, here we have a shell, right? So let's try to, who am I? So we are IIS Apple Web, right? Then try to go to back, then CD DIR
9 1 9
DIR, right? Then go to CD users LS. DIR, sorry, and CD babies. So access is denied, right? So we have we are a very low level shell, right? So now we have to escalate some local privileges, right? So for that we have to check what is the version of Windows and what is the is there any hotfix which are not which are vulnerable, right? So for that we just type system. Guys, there are lots of ways to check the privilege escalation, right? Like for some Explorer suggester or something. But today I am going to solve this using manual method, right? So I'll type here system info, right? So we got the information from for all the version and directories, right? So here you can see our OS name is Microsoft Windows 7. OS version 6.1.0 7600, right? So guys, during my job and all the things, many more time I just exploited the Windows 7 version, right? That 7600, which have I remember that there are lots of local privilege escalation exploits, right? So for that, let's try to Google it, right? For local privilege escalation, right? So here I go with the Windows 7. 7600 exploit. Okay, so there we have. Six point one. This is one. This is two. Okay. Anything else we have? Let's go through this. So there is a local privilege escalation. Okay. Then mySMB, we don't need that. This is a. So we have to type here local. Local privilege escalation, right? So here we have this one and this one also, right? So this is 8ft.sys local privilege MS1106. FD. Right, so guys, this is the exploit, right? Which have proper documentation how we can compile it and how we can exploit, right? As you can see, it says exploiting compiling Kali Linux using this compiler, right? So first of all, we have to download it, right? So how we can download it? Just click on download button, and we are able to download it. Then copy this, right? Or just go to our terminal, right? C drive. Then we type copy root downloads four something. It started from four, right? It's 406. Then copy it into the root desktop, our OSCP directory, OSCP, STB, retired. Devel, then space dot. We have to put dash R, right? And CD as root desktop OSCP STB Devel. Sorry, retired devel ls. So where is our exploit? We have our exploit, right? Sorry, I made some mistakes, right? So that is a 404 405645. So how we can compile it? We just have to run this command, right? i6, and this will be our output. So we saved it as Kamal projects.exe. Right, and press enter. So it says error, no such file directory. That is 40. Oh, sorry, I'm making some mistakes. So it's getting compiled, right? So it take 2 or 3 minutes. No, it's just finished, right? Then ls, here we have composer.exe. So now we have to run this composer.projects.exe file in our FTP, right? Or directory shell. There are two or three methods. So here I'm using SMB, setup SMB client on my Kali Linux machine. Then via SMB machine, SMB client, I will run this composer.projects.exe onto the server using a low level shell, right? So how we can do that? Just we have to do just the thing, locate SMB server, right? Locate SMB. So what, sorry guys, I'm just making some mistake. SMB server, server, right? So there, here we go, copy it, right? Then Python should be, and here I type a temp, then the name of our path of directory, stb oscp stb retired devel, enter, right? Then we'll go to our shell, then we type here 10.40 dot what was my IP address, if config 40.33, exit 33 temp slash camel projects dot exe, press enter, then go to Python. So here we get authenticator successful, then go to our shell. Okay, so here we can see who am I. So we are the anti authority, then we are type a dir, no, just first of all go to cd dir root dot txt slash s maybe, no file. So it can be maybe sometimes in ctfs you will find dot txt file, or you have to type double extension, right? So here you can see we are able to find the root.txt file, and also we are able to find user.txt.txt as user.txt. It's 32-bit, it's probably a flag for devel. So thanks guys, hope you enjoy my video. Today I'm just making some pauses in the video because I got a phone calls and there's some raining outside. So that's why I just make pauses two or three times. But if you feel that I'm missing something, just please comment it down. And thanks for the watching guys. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thanks guys.